Port forwarding is an easy way to access the Qlik PLCs that are on their own network behind a router. But it's not a very secure way to access those PLCs. So if network security is a concern for you, then you'll want to use a virtual private network or a VPN to access your Qlik PLCs. We'll cover VPNs in a separate video. In this port forwarding demo, we'll be using a PC at IP address 172.31.51.60, going to a router on the same subnet at .57. The Qlik PLCs will be behind the router on their own local 192.168 network at these addresses. To communicate with the Qlik PLCs, we'll send all of our messages to the router over this 172.31 network, but we'll append a unique port number to the router's IP address to tell the router which Qlik we want to talk to. Then inside the router, we'll set up a table to cross-reference those port numbers to the local network IP addresses where the Qliks are. So the router will take the messages sent to it and use the appended port numbers to figure out which Qliks to forward the message to, hence the name port forwarding. We're using a Cisco Linksys E1000 router, and it has a dedicated port to connect to the external network and four ports for the local area network, or LAN. Let's connect the external network port on the router to the PC using this USB to Ethernet adapter. I've already set up the adapter's static IP address to the 172.31.51.60 that we'll be using in this demo. Your network will probably have a different IP address, of course. Well, that takes care of this connection. Then we'll connect a laptop PC to one of the LAN ports on the router and set it to this IP address, so we can configure the router using its default 192.168.1.1 IP address and access its built-in configuration utility. Now, do you have to use two PCs like this? No, you could use one, but then you'd have to keep swapping cables and network adapter configurations and IP addresses, and it's real easy to get things mixed up and confused, and when you do that, it just creates unnecessary frustration. Keeping them separate like this makes it really easy to play with the router settings from the LAN side while you're tweaking your PLC network on the external side of the router. So having two PCs like this just keeps things clean and simple. Let's also add the Qlik Ethernet connections to the LAN side of the router. Now, I've already set up the Qlik Ethernet IP addresses before I started this video. If you need to see how to do that, check out the Qlik Ethernet PLC Quick Start video. Okay, we're all wired up, and the networking around the router is configured, so now we need to set up the router. That's over on the laptop, so you can't see it on this video, so I'm going to just show you screenshots of what it looks like. From the laptop, I logged into the router using its default LAN IP address, which for this router is 192.168.1.1. There was a login screen, which for this router was admin admin. In the basic setup menu, this router was set up for DHCP, so it could get its IP address automatically from the network. I changed it to a static IP and mask to ensure that it's on the same subnet as the PC with the Qlik software, which was at 172.31.51.60. So I just set the router at .57, so it'd be different from that .60. And even though we don't have a gateway in our simple little demo here, this router required I enter something, so I use this. If you are going through another router, then you'll want to add its IP address here as the gateway. I also had to go over to the security page and turn off this filter internet requests so I could ping the router and test my connection. Okay, that takes care of the external PC connection to the router. If I ping the router from the PC, sure enough, I see a response. Perfect. This side of the router is ready to go. Now let's do the LAN side of the router. Back on the basic setup menu, we're using the router's default LAN IP address here with this subnet mask, and we don't need DHCP since we're only talking to our Qlik PLCs, which all have fixed IP addresses. I did a ping from the laptop, and sure enough, I could reach both Qlik PLCs. So all the networking on this side of the router seems to be working. Perfect. I should mention I also turned off the wireless functionality of this router. The IT guys here hate it when we bring up extraneous Wi-Fi signals. Okay, and finally, if we go over to port forwarding, which on this router is under the Applications and Gaming menu, you can see I gave each Qlik a name, specified the port numbers that will come from the Qlik development software on the PC, the local IP address of each Qlik PLC, and the Qlik's port number. Now that's the same fixed port number on every Qlik PLC, which by the way, it corresponds to CLICK on a telephone keypad. So any messages that come into the router on this port number will be forwarded to this IP address in this port number. Any messages that come in with this port number will be sent to this port number and IP address. Now, here's a key point. The router you use has to have the ability to specify the Qlik PLC's port number like this. Some of the routers I tested wouldn't let me specify the Qlik's port number, so I couldn't use them for port forwarding to the Qlik PLC. This Netgear router's port forwarding is a good example. I can specify a range of external ports coming into the router, but there's no place to put the Qlik's port number, or what some routers call the internal port number. So watch out for that. And while I spent a lot of time explaining things, all we really did was wire the PC and the Qlik PLCs to the router, set up our network addressing, and configure the router to talk to the PC and the Qliks and to forward messages. That's it. The bottom line is, all this stuff we've done so far is stuff you need to do with your network and your router and your IT guys. And while your router and your network will be different from this, hopefully you now have a better idea of what to look for and what you need to do. Okay, well, enough router stuff. Let's set up the Qlik PLCs for port forwarding. The good news is, once you've done all of your networking setup, connecting to the Qlik PLCs on the LAN side of a router is easy. Start the Qlik software, and just like always, we want to connect to a PLC. Except these PLCs on the other side of a router, right? We want to connect via Ethernet, and we want to do it using the PC's Ethernet adapter that's connected to the router. Select outside this LAN, and that graphic changes to show us we're now trying to connect to a PLC that's behind a router. The Qlik software can't see those Qlik PLCs behind the router, so we have to tell it how to find them by adding them to this list. Hit the Add button. We'll give this connection a name and specify the address of the router that the Qliks are behind. And here's that port number again. This is the port number the router will use to forward the message to the Qlik. If we go back and look at that port forwarding table we put in the router, we see Qlik number 1 is on this port, so we put that here. And let's go ahead and create the other Qlik PLC's connection too. Add, give it a name, the router's IP address, and the port number the router's expecting for Qlik number 2's messages. Notice that you can't blink the LEDs to test the connection when working through a router, so we'll just have to try the connection and see what happens. So we'll select the first Qlik PLC and hit connect. And sure enough, we get the expected dialog. Perfect. If I choose to read the current project from the PLC, I'll get all of its ladder code and settings, including the settings for the Ethernet port on the Qlik. Instead, I'm going to choose don't read the project, because I want to show you something. Great, we're connected. Well, that was easy. We just set up the connection table so the ports matched what we did in the router, and we're up and running. Now here's the thing I wanted to show you. Because we didn't read the project out of the Qlik PLC, the COM port settings didn't get brought into this project. You can see this project has the COM port set for .99 right now. If I write this project to the PLC, the software sees the difference and says, are you sure you want to change the IP address of the Qlik PLC? The PLC says his IP address is currently this, and you're trying to change it to this. Are you sure? Well, no, I really want this IP address, so I hit this button and everything continues as planned. Well, how cool is that? The Qlik PLC software is watching your back and doing everything it can to keep you straight. I love that. Let's disconnect from Qlik number 1 and connect to Qlik number 2. This time, let's read the project from the Qlik PLC. Give it a few seconds to sync everything up. And if we go back to that COM port settings dialog, we see Qlik number 2's COM port settings were read into the project along with the ladder code. Perfect. So, once you get your network set up to do port forwarding, implementing it on the Qlik PLC is just filling in a table in the connection dialog, isn't it? Not bad at all. If you need any help with the Qlik PLC or any of Automation Direct's tens of thousands of parts, please contact Automation Direct's free, award-winning tech support during regular business hours. They'll be happy to help you. But please, don't call them looking for help on your router or your network setup. They aren't set up or trained to do that. And of course, don't forget the forums. There are lots of folks there that love to share their years of experience.